First one is, where are you from?
Born and raised in Florida.
And how'd you get your start in wrestling?
I was recruited by the Hulkster, man. He's also a Florida boy. He got me going.
He was a good friend of yours, correct?
Best friend of mine.
Right. So who trained you? Obviously, it was the Hulkster.
Well, he started my training. Basically, I didn't go to a school, man. I trained every night in the ring wrestling. My school was on the road in the ring every night. That's the best way to learn.
Do you remember your first match?
Absolutely. It was a tag match in Alabama against Eric the Red and Ox Baker.
Who was your partner?
Ron Slinker, an old camper boy, also an ex-cop.
Oh, great. Now, what federations have you worked for?
All of them.
Everywhere, right? Even Japan, everywhere, right?
Yep.
Give me the list of titles, as you can remember them, that you've held.
World Federation Tag Team titles twice. A North American title, Georgia title. Southern tag team titles with, a couple different times, television title. I'm the New England champion right now, heavyweight champion. Just on and on, brother. Over the years, there's been a lot of titles.
This is our favorite question. Give me a rib that you've either done or you've seen in the dressing room.
A rib? Shoot, seen a lot of them. I saw the British Bulldogs used to take my scissors and cut people's pants legs off their pants when it was about 20 below zero outside. That was pretty fun.
That's a good one. Give me your impression on today's wrestling product.
Well, it's just changed a lot. I don't really keep up with what's on TV these days very much. I'm pretty busy. I got a family. My daughter's 10 years old. It's a different kind of product that I'm used to. It's not really what my idea of the wrestling business is, so I really don't keep up with that much. You know, I mean, a few people like it, but the general consensus from everybody I know is that it's not up to snuff.
I agree wholeheartedly. What was your favorite match of all time?
Brother, I've had so many. I've been in 10 WrestleManias. All those matches were fantastic. I've been in a lot of matches with Hulkster and WrestleMania and Caesar's Palace, Silverdome in Pontiac, Michigan, in front of 100,000 people. I guess that was one of the best.
This is kind of an odd question. Can you give me three of the greatest wrestlers in your opinion of all time?
Yeah, myself, Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant.
There you go. That's a good list. How about one that didn't work for you?
One that didn't work?
Yeah.
Probably Adrian Adonis. Rest his soul now. He's dead. I knew him. For many years back from Minneapolis days, in 1980, I met him. I got along with him then. I got along with him in Japan, and then he hooked up with Dirty Dick Dick Murdoch, the All-American Redneck or something they used to call him, I guess, the guy from Texas, and for some reason, he didn't like me. He didn't like Hulkster either, and he convinced Adrian that I was evil and that I was trying to get his wife or something. I don't know. And he accused me of all kind of things, and then left the territory in the WWF after WrestleMania 3. And then within a year, he was killed in an accident.
Wow.
Probably the only guy I really never got along with.
Who was your favorite opponent, a guy you liked working with in the ring?
Mr. Perfect.
Kurt, yeah.
Yeah.
Give me your impression on Vince McMahon.
Well, he's a brilliant businessman. You know, guys are flair for the entertainment business. I mean, no doubt about it, but he's got a bit of a mean streak and he kind of really thinks he's better than you, and he thinks he's better than me, and that doesn't work for me in the real world.
Brutus, where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Hopefully in a nice big mansion retired somewhere in Florida.
There you go. Last of the 20 questions is, what is the one thing you want to be remembered for from your fans?
I'd have to say that at least that I was a straight-up guy. I was a good wrestler, a man of his word, not a coward, and not a liar. You know, someone who lived up to his reputation, that was a good man, a good wrestler.
Well, I don't think there's going to be any problem with that. What we'd like to do here on every show is we'd like to take a second out, Ed, and say on behalf of the Brutal Truth, on behalf of all my listeners and wrestling fans over the years, thank you for all the abuse that you put your body through. Thank you for all the times that you went out there and you entertained us. We are definitely have fond memories of Brutus the Barber Beefcake, and you are exactly what legends are made of, brother. Everybody knows who Hulk Hogan is, Jake the Snake, Andre the Giant, and they know who Brutus the Barber Beefcake is. Thank you very much for being on our show.
Hey, no problem, man. It's my pleasure, man. I love to get out and get on the airwaves and touch the people out there, man. There's a lot of great fans in the wrestling world, and it's a privilege to be able to talk to them.
Ed, take care of that beautiful family of yours who see the picture on MySpace, and thank you again for being on The Brutal Truth.
Hey, thanks a lot, brother.
All right, wrestling fans, I hope you enjoyed that interview with Ed Leslie, one of the greatest of all time, if you have to say myself, the WWF legend, and everyone knows who Brutus the Barber Beefcake is. In the upcoming months, we'll have special interviews with many of the professional wrestlers, a lot of the legends, a lot of the upcoming stars, as well as the guys featured right here in New York State. Now we want to go to something classic. That's the Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame in Amsterdam, New York. We touched on it last time and gave you a little special feature, but now we want to show you something very special. It is a promo video given to me by President Tony Villano. He is the curator and president and creator of the Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame, as you might have seen in the last show. This is a special segment from the induction ceremony in May, and you will see why the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame is not only special to fans, but the legendary wrestlers themselves. Let's take a look at that now.